All right, I'm going to entitle this podcast, Why Aren't You Famous Yet? Let's do this. It's going to be fun.
I spent the last 14 years playing over 1,000 shows, touring 22 different countries, and become a top 40 Billboard charting artist. I fired my record label to go out on my own as an independent artist to market and release my own music, selling thousands of albums and millions of streams. The question I always get is, how did I do it without a label and sell even more music? This podcast is here to show you the way. Join me and follow along as I learn, apply, and share marketing strategies to grow my music business and a loyal fan base.
So, I just got off or out of Starbucks. I was working this morning, got up at like 6:30 a.m. and 6:15. I think I was working by 6:40. I don't even know, but I like to get up early. I like to do some certain things, check my Facebook ads, write emails, just get organized right before my wife and daughter wake up. And now it's like 8 something and I'm going to go for a walk and record a couple podcasts for you guys. But I was thinking, I was just about to post something on Instagram, and I saw somebody had added one of my songs to their stories, a fan, and he was like the most underrated artist. And I've gotten that a lot. And I'm not saying that to be egotistical or anything like that, but I've heard that a lot, and maybe you've heard it too. But the question is, what are we going to do about it? You know what I mean? Like, I believe that. Like, for me, I believe that I should be, you know, a lot bigger than I am. And it's weird, because I had a dream the other night of all these shows that we used to do and stuff. And, you know, to be honest, a lot of times I had not the best time slot sometimes. Like, I think I should have always had a better time slot, should have been playing, whether that's festivals or tours. And I'm not, this isn't like a complaining podcast. This is like just reflecting and saying kind of like, okay, if all these things are true, well then what are you going to do about it to fix it moving forward? And, you know, at first I was looking at some of my data and I was like, okay, I'm going to post this song on Instagram and I'm going to promote it again. And I was thinking to myself, is posting my song again on Instagram, is that really going to get the results I want? Is that really going to get it? You know, it's you posting your song to the same 1,000 followers, 10,000, 20,000 followers, really going to get you where you want? Is it going to get you the mass exposure you want? And I'm probably going to go with no, it's probably not. And I started thinking to myself, like, you know, what am I going to do to get this song out there then? Stop complaining. And I'm looking at my data and I'm seeing one of my songs is called Insomnia is doing really, really well just on its own, kind of organically. And so I'm like, okay, I need to create an ad and I need to promote this thing, like, massively. Like, I need this being seen by tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people that have never heard of me. Otherwise, I'm just going to stay in Dorkton, okay? And Dorkton is a reference of that movie Social Network that Zuckerberg says to his buddy when they're just launching Facebook, and he's like, dude, I need emails of your more famous friends and stuff. Because he's like, otherwise, just the same eyes and ears are going to see this, and it's never going to get the massive exposure that we need Facebook to get. Okay, and this is coming from Facebook, okay? And now, obviously, Facebook is like a juggernaut of size and the most incredible platform. And so, I think the same thing. I don't want my songs just bouncing around Dorkton around my same old fans. I want new eyes on this. I want people that have never heard of me before. And isn't that why we try and get on radio? Isn't that why we make music videos and do all these things or get on shows? Because we want more people to hear the music, right? And but yet we continue to do the same things over and over again and expect different results. We know the definition of that is insanity. And I'm asking myself, why am I doing some of the same stupid similar things that aren't working? And I want you to stop before you post again next time and think, okay, is this working? Or maybe I'm posting to see which songs are working and which ones I'm going to now leverage and put some money behind. Okay, now that's strategic. And that's what I need to do is look at the posts, look at the songs that are working, look at the data. And it's incredible when you look at the data to see like how you're being searched and stuff. Like, there's one tool I use called VidIQ for YouTube. And It shows me all the what people are searching for, what my most popular videos are, and you know, one of my older songs is still one of the most popular. But what's some of the new ones that I've released? Which ones are just kind of getting some of that organic love, like so I can take money and jack that up? Because like, look, it's 2020, and I don't want the same results as 2019. I want bigger results. I want to really smash this out, and I know it's by getting my music in front of new fans, new people. And that's what your songs are. They're all different angles to talk about your music to new fans. Me specifically, I've got people that I can target in the hip-hop, rock, and then the Christian audience. Three different ones. And honestly, I should be running three different things and getting massive amounts of people in there. And the question is, why am I not even doing a better job at this? Well, as I'm recording this, it's only January 2nd, so I got to give myself a little bit of leeway. But my point is, I'm fed up and I'm kind of frustrated, and I want you to get frustrated too, because if you're like, why am I not famous yet, or why am I'm so underrated, nobody's heard of me. Well, like, well, what are you doing to invest? Are you spending more money on your haircuts and your clothes than you are on your marketing and actually getting your music out there? You know? Like, what are you doing? Well, I'm going for it. You know, after this post today, I'm going to be building a funnel. And I am going to be to promote my music so I can just make money on my music as well as getting it out there. And I'm willing to invest now to get the pay later. I'm willing to risk. Are you going to be willing to risk? Or are you just going to always dip your toe in? Or are you going to jump right in and go for it? And obviously you don't want to do that stupidly, and that's why I'm going to be having a workshop at smartmusicbusiness.com/save-your-seat. I'm going to be doing an awesome Facebook and Instagram ads for workshops so you can build a funnel and not only get fans, but get their contact information, promote your music, and also have a way to monetize it and get your ROI, at least break even and make money in the long run and build your fan base and build it and build it and build it and build it on autopilot. That's what I'm going to be teaching you, and it's going to be freaking awesome. Instead of you just on the treadmill of posting something every day and it not even doing anything to grow your business, you know, you want to take one thing and amplify that and get it out there to the masses. That's the strategy I want to teach you. So, hey, I want to remind you that a fighter isn't someone who never fails. A fighter is someone who never quits. Peace. So if you're a struggling artist and you're just trying to figure out this music industry, you want to go full time with your music, you want to get noticed on social media or learn how to launch an album, an EP, or just get your music more marketed out there, I want to encourage you to check out my coaching program called Fanbase University. Every single month, I jump on the phone 2 times with my students and I coach them and I teach them how to market their music, how to get noticed, how to handle booking agents, record labels, and just get their music out there. Also, you get access to exclusive training. You get interviews with music industry professionals. If you want to find out more and not do this on your own, not struggle, because I've wasted thousands of dollars on my career and now I want to coach other artists. Check out my program, fanbaseuniversity.com, or click the link below to find out more info.